first come here to make sure he keeps his fish refrigerated, so to speak. But you see, apart from not being able to hear each other, they're quite happy to talk to you. They're happy you talk to them, because a lot of foreigners don't talk to people. Garden, and people often come to swim in the morning and even to wash themselves. One of the locals, I didn't notice it behind me, and he didn't say good morning. There you go. See how shallow it is. You have to go quite a long way out to be in deep water. If you're northeast, then you've got to go out far enough to put your clippers on. What I normally do is get out a bit further than him, carrying my clippers. Then I sit down, take a breath, and sit down on the bottom before my clippers on. Yeah, I'm going to get through. There'll be more people around the other side of the barn. People like Gary and myself, who are either snorkeling, spear fishing, or what. We come here because it's a bit of a rocky bottom here, and so the people who are coming swimming like to go the other side where it's sandy, so we keep separation between the spear fishermen swimming around, for obvious reasons. Anyway, Gary's a long way out by now. I see a few kilometres out. But I'm sure if he doesn't take too long, he might be out there hours. In which case, hard luck, because I have to go and have some stretch. If I eat at an eatery, little food place run by a mom and pop and their two nieces, and I have my breakfast there, and I try to have a good breakfast, because I often forget to eat. As was the case. Well, I did eat a little bit yesterday evening, but I stock up on rice and whatever delicious local food they've got. I like all of the food. There's very few things I won't eat. One of them is balut, which is this egg. Matured into a young pigfish, and that's disgusting. Let me have a look. I will walk back. If I, it's probably worth filming.